Welcome to the YGTV News with Bouchra El Mansouri.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Wednesday the 6th of June. I'm Bouchra El Mansouri. Keith Azopardi steps down as PDP leader. Local human rights activist reports Guardia civil attack. Two land cruisers stolen from Corral Road. Picardo speaks with UK ministers during Jubilee. ESG warns public on beach sewage. And finally, education clinic to give free advice on boarding schools. This morning it was announced that PDP leader Keith Azopardi will be stepping down from his position. Within his personal resignation statement, Mr. Azopardi noted that Nick Cruz would take over as leader of the party until a new one could be elected at an AGM in September. Insisting that he will continue to support the party, Mr. Azopardi claimed that this has not been an easy decision for him, but after more than 20 years in politics, he feels it is right to take a break. The final decision, he noted, was affected by a personal assessment of Mr. Azopardi's motivation in the current political panorama and his desire to do other things. Locally known human rights activist and chairman of equality rights group, Felix Alvarez, filed an official complaint with the Spanish court following an aggressive attack by a Spanish civil guard in the Frontier Customs building. Describing the incident, Mr. Alvarez explained that after he declared two individual packets of cigarettes when crossing through the Spanish Customs building, he was called back by an older civil guard who took him into a small back room and beat him repeatedly. Once he was let go, Mr. Alvarez noted that he is making a call against abuse and has informed various Gibraltarian institutions on the attack. Last night, at approximately 1:30 a.m, two Toyota Land Cruisers were stolen from outside local car dealer DC Motors. One of the vehicles was bottle green with the registration number G6171A. The thieves were caught on CCTV camera wearing balaclavas. An investigation into the theft is ongoing. Owner of DC Motors, Derek Delmedo, was unavailable to comment at this time. During Mr. and Mrs. Picardo's visit to London for the Diamond Jubilee weekend, they spoke with the Earl and Countess of Wessex, who confirmed that they were looking forward to visiting Gibraltar next week. Mr. Picardo also chatted to UK Prime Minister David Cameron about the topical issues affecting Gibraltar, during which Mr. Cameron reiterated his support for Gibraltar. The Chief Minister also spoke with Chancellor George Osborne about the UK government's proposals in respecting of a consumption tax relating to online gaming. In a meeting with Foreign Secretary William Hague, Mr. Picardo discussed issues relating to the Guardia Civil's incursions into Gibraltar territorial waters and other Gibraltar issues. As bathing season is close, the ESG is warning the public to remain vigilant and aware of the continued threat of sewage pollution from La Niña, affecting the northern beaches of Gibraltar. Environmental agency statistics claim that currently Western Beach should be safe for bathing. There is warning, though, that the sewage is now being displaced towards beaches on the eastern side of the rock. The ESG is urging the government to increase sampling to verify water quality closer to the airport runway. The group also notes that Western Beach should remain closed for now, as the displaced sewage could return to the bay area. And finally, on Thursday the 28th of June, the Education Clinic will be visiting the Lion Bar Europa to give free impartial help and advice on finding the best boarding school for children. The Education Clinic is aimed at giving advice on boarding school to forces families. The event will begin at 9 a.m. and end at 11 a.m. That's the YGTV News. We're back tomorrow. See you then.